all the way from Cosmo City. And it's kind of like also when you're looking at rural issues, you look at issue of accessibility, you look at issue of affordability, you look at issues of comprehension. So, you know, and so affordability in terms of what is affordable for people to access, what is close by for people to go to, what do people understand and relate and resonate with that they can be able to go to. So you don't look at it as in, oh, they go there because they have nowhere else to go, or they go there because it's cheaper. It's all of those things that really have people come to people like us, traditional healers. So what we do, and this is what people need to understand, I think traditional healers, and not all of us have the language to articulate it the way that I do, but it doesn't mean they don't know what I'm saying. Because sometimes language becomes an issue for us, because we need to find words in which we can express what we do in mainstream language. And mainstream language is limited in its vocabulary, that it can articulate what we do best. So who we are is people who really understand the complexity of human beings. That human beings are a complex organism, that's science, right? Mm-hmm. So that we're not just, you know, biology, but we're a spiritual entity as well. So we are this body that most of us can relate, that is, you know, has an anatomy of male, female, and the rest, that includes those things. But we're also a spiritual being. And that's a non-tangible physical entity, but it exists, and it's a very powerful entity, whether you believe in it or not. And we also the mind. And when we work as traditional healers, is to try and understand when you come to us, what is it that is a discord at those levels. So we're not only trained to understand symptoms and biological symptoms that people present themselves with, but we are trained to understand other elements. You are trained to understand psychology. You are trained to understand spirituality. So it's a really in-depth understanding of human life. However, it's also limited. It doesn't mean that it's in-depth, it's rich, and therefore it's complete. Because when you look at the topic of, you know, mainstream or Western medicine versus traditional, you know, I don't know why people like to verse things, eh? Because when we verse things, we are putting value proposition over the other. We are being, you know, comparative. And a lot of times when you compare what has been documented and well articulated in articles, in journals, to something that has been carried from generation to generation in oral tradition, it becomes problematic. Because when I'm talking and you sitting, you're like, but yeah, where's the proof? Where's the evidence? You know? And also our proof and how we present evidence, sometimes science fails to recognize it. And maybe not necessarily science, I think sometimes different paradigms, especially Western thinking, fails to understand it. Because I think with Western thinking, it's gotta be in a particular way, it's gotta be a cause and an effect type of situation in order for it to kind of be validated. But in our way, we understand that human beings are complex, and sometimes it's not an A to a B situation. It requires a bit of a detour before you can get to the other side. So what I've grown up knowing sangomas to be practitioners who get rid of witches, or they were witches themselves. And that's very limited, again, you know, thinking that that's all they do. I was freaked out by them. I didn't even go to them. I didn't even believe in them. I prayed for them and thought one day they will be redeemed and find a savior or somebody to help them out of their doomness. But without recognizing that actually those are limiting belief systems about what traditional health practitioners practice. And it's also a belief system that is still rife in our 21st century, where people believe this is all mambo jumbo spiritual things. They have no understanding of biology or of the patient's need. We don't know what's going on. We think everything amatlos. Well, pete kanda ihlosi, hambo hlabi imbuzi. Yabona uphethwe isizwe, hayi ihlosi, lifuna inkukhu. You know, people think that that's all that we understand. But because we understand that human beings are complex, when people come to our practice room, and those who have said in some of my talks, I've said this before, you don't tell me what's wrong with you. I tell you what's wrong with you. And I tell you your symptoms, but I look beyond the symptoms and see what is at discord at a root level with you and what is therefore required for you to be well again. And when you work with healers and traditional healers, abenis tunes, Baba, of high integrity, we know what is not for us to make well. We know where we are limited with. So the problem becomes when we have to explain things in language. So if I say to somebody, because we also are people who really practice a lot of sacredness and we revere a lot of things, and also, you know, when you're talking to a human being who you could see that actually this person is, let me use the HIV example, this person is HIV positive and already they're falling apart emotionally, you're not going to say, you know what's wrong with you, I think you've got AIDS or you've got HIV, why don't you go get tested? You have to find a language in which this person can feel taken care of and supported and then open themselves up for further support and caring of. So you have to be able to say, Gogo, and Zoshong is Zulune, Gogo no man cool. Looking upon a lago, who connect us in a unga, abunam pilikas in lag. Ongatu ungayagum tolampil. Movi agum tolampil, batin jebans a matest, yabon, babo no putting a secazin. Ugu pilanga pilanga corn. Upindubu ye. Mosu could leg in putting on gem, which went besses born out to seven in Sanaganja. Next is a translator another time. So that's what we do, because when people come to us, it's not a 15 or a 10 minute consultation. It is sometimes because we just get to it and people like, okay, I've heard it, what do I need to do, and walk out. But sometimes it's a 2 hour or a 4 hour consultation, because we need to provide different types of support, because somebody might come with a headache, a severe migraine, but it's actually nothing. Again, there's no chemistry imbalance. It's just that the person is not well. They need somebody to listen, somebody who can listen to them. And they have no access. They can't afford a psychologist. And they cannot comprehend the language of psychology, because that language was written somewhere else. And sometimes it's not applicable to them. We know that psychology is quite limited in understanding African psychoticness that is associated with being called to heal. We know that. So we need to start really, as Ubaba was saying, we need to start saying everything. And this is not, again, a competition. It's to say, where are the limitations? And where are our effectiveness that as we work, we can find some sort of alignment? I'm not a strong believer of integration, because it will be probably difficult if I get integrated in a mainstream hospital, because there are fire centers. It will be very difficult because again, it's also associated as a belief system that other people cannot, you know, they would feel that they're not accustomed to. But in Pepe, it's a medicinal plant on its own. So when we burn it, it's because we're carrying energy and we're carrying the air around. When we boil it, it's because the properties that exist in that medicinal plant can be ingested and they can facilitate some healing. I don't know, again, what it is in English. Those big scientific words are hard to pronounce. I'm sure for you as well. And maybe you spend half of your studies trying to figure out to pronounce them better. You know? So that's why I give this in pep. Even imitating Abu Matunga, Abu Mhlabelo, Abu Mhlonyane, these are plants that we grew up with, that Abu Koko and Abu Koko Mkulu grew up with. So these medicines existed way before time and they had nothing to do with the spiritual belief systems. Do you hear what I'm saying? They had nothing.